Razgovor s Valerijom Olđijatijem donosi vam Velux.
Kada vidite njegove različite projekte, s pravom se može reći da imaju prepoznatljiv potpis. Čista i pomalo šokantna forma nema nikakvu namjeru uklopiti se u kontekst u kojem se nalazi.
Of course I react on context, I make an entrance towards the right place of the environment. I have neighbors, you know, that I will kind of that I react to. I have a topography eventually I will react to, but this I consider this to be technical aspects of architecture and not of aspects that kind of give a reason, you know, or that are kind of the inspiring or kind of the creative aspects of to make architecture.
Jer, kako kažu njegovi kolege, većina ostalih arhitekata pristaje na kompromise. Valerij Olđijati ne. Za njega arhitektura ne treba samo izgledati interesantno, nego i biti interesantna.
I just see that in contemporary architecture that architects do less and less, they make something out of an idea, they make it more and more out of a context, because this is what everybody understands. And I find a pity that it is like this.
Zato svoje studente uči da nije sve u crtanju. Prije crtanja svoju ideju treba formulirati riječima, jer čak i pisci razmisle prije nego krenu pisati.
For example, very simple. If a student just starts to draw something, then I look at the drawing and say, oh wow, beautiful or what, then I don't know what it is, it's just something, you know. But if a student, for example, tells me, I want to make a house which is mainly a garden, I want that my house is a garden, then I start to think of something.
Mnogi se ne mogu oteti dojmu da je njegova arhitektura definirana konstrukcijom koju uopće ne pokušava sakriti. I zato postoji razlog.
I love machines, you know, like since I was a child, and I really like to construct and to build, and I from the first moment on that I design, I think of how I would build it. This is not, of course I like this personally, but I also think that, let's say, as an architect at the end, if you are not able to build what you think, This is not good. It's not good for you, not good for architecture.
Smatra da je najveća profesionalna frustracija arhitekata upravo to da ne mogu graditi ono što su zamislili. S tim se njegovim razmišljanjem nije teško složiti, ali za teoriju o horizontalnim prozorima za ruralna područja i vertikalnim za urbana trebali smo objašnjenje.
In front of a vertical windows we can also look outside, but we feel more kind of the light and what is outside. But as soon as we are in front of a horizontal window, we start to look outside. We start to watch.
Jer na selu pogled seže u prirodu, a u gradu često gledate u susjedovu fasadu koja nije uvijek privlačna. Zato prozori u gradu imaju funkciju unošenja zdravog dnevnog svjetla u dom i mogu biti i vertikalni.
I don't have, like, let's say, a magic way of dealing with light, you know, or like a recipe. But of course, when we are in a house or when we are in a building, everybody wants to know if it's daytime or nighttime. And also when we are living in an underground building, we would like to know if it is daytime or not.
Unijeti svjetlost u interijer posebno je izazovno u potkrovlju. Rješenje za to ima Velux koji je omogućio produkciju intervjua s poznatim arhitektom. Kao vodeći svjetski proizvođač krovnih prozora, već više od 80 godina dovode dnevnu svjetlost i svjež zrak u prostore ispod krova. U Veluxu smatraju da većim fokusom na udobnost, potrošnju energije i utjecaj na okoliš možemo stvarati zdravije zgrade, dobre za ljude i svijet u kojem živimo. U svojem programu nude krovne prozore za kose i ravne krovove, svjetlosne tunele, sjenila i rolete te dodatnu opremu za daljinsko ili automatizirano upravljanje putem senzora.